Understanding the Initial Management of Diabetic Ketoacidosis by Dr. Michael Agus.
DKA is a problem of insulin deficiency. The cure for DKA is insulin therapy. Glucose is really an innocent bystander. It's affected by insulin therapy, but it's not part of the problem. The problem is insulin deficiency, and we need to correct that problem.
Initial management.
The normal saline bolus. In the emergency department, we will generally give 10 milliliters per kilo, and that's been a component of most treatment algorithms throughout most of the literature. The real question is, do you give that second or third or fourth bolus? And it is extremely uncommon to need much volume beyond 10 per kilo, and beyond 20 per kilo is extremely rare. Now, one has to resolve and kind of internally understand that, unlike almost every other volume bolus we give in pediatrics, the idea of the volume bolus in DKA is not to restore euvolemia. It is to restore end organ perfusion such that those end organs don't suffer significant injury. The amount needed to restore end organ perfusion is very small. The amount needed to restore euvolemia is quite significant, but if you restored euvolemia in every patient with DKA, you would be doing a lot of harm. That's why we restrict fluids to 10 per kilo in general, 20 per kilo rarely. But I will say that in the extremely unlikely situation that someone comes in with DKA and shock, they may need 80 per kilo. So there is no correct amount of fluid to give a patient with DKA. You give the patient what they need. But again, it's not what they need to get to be euvolemic, it's what they need to avoid end organ dysfunction due to ischemia. In terms of insulin therapy, it's really amazing to remember that the half-life, the serum half-life of IV insulin is between 3 and 5 minutes. Insulin is very quickly utilized or broken down in the serum. And so one achieves steady state with a continuous insulin infusion, at least a steady state concentration, within 3 to 4 half-lives, or 15, 20 minutes. So the utility of an insulin bolus was always a little bit in question. Recently, however, though, there was an interesting cohort study in the United Kingdom which demonstrated that any insulin given in the first hour increases the risk of significant cerebral edema quite markedly. And so we've now shifted away from giving any insulin in the first hour, and we certainly don't give any boluses at this point. So based on all this data, we proceed by giving our normal saline bolus, as I mentioned, usually 10 mLs per kilo over the first hour. And at the end of that first hour, we start the insulin infusion without a bolus, without a loading dose. We give it at 0.1 units per kilogram per hour as a continuous infusion.